Today's scripture comes from Acts 16, 22 through 30. The crowd joined in the attack against Paul and Silas, and the magistrates ordered them to be stripped and beaten. After they had been severely flogged, they were thrown into prison, and the jailer was commanded to guard them carefully. Upon receiving such orders, he put them in the inner cell and fastened their feet in the stocks. About midnight, Paul and Silas were praying and singing hymns to God, and the other prisoners were listening to them. Suddenly, there was such a violent earthquake that the foundations of the prison were shaken. At once, all the prison doors flew open, and everybody's chains became loose. The jailer woke up, and when he saw the prison doors open, he drew his sword and was about to kill himself because he thought the prisoners had escaped. But Paul shouted, "Don't harm yourself, we are all here." May the Lord add his blessing to the reading and hearing of his holy word.
Let me start by saying that I am proud to be able to preach the sermon here today at Trinity. Believe it or not, I am the third generation of Sapmen to preach from this very pulpit. And you know what they say? They say three is a charm and save the best for last. Well, I guess they're right. Well, my dad asked me if I would be willing to preach a sermon today. I said, maybe? I've never preached before, so I was hesitant. I didn't know if I would be any good at it or not, but I thought it was worth a shot. I guess we'll find out if I was right or not. I knew that people fell asleep every week for my dad's sermons, so I thought, I can't do any worse than that. Unless everyone falls asleep. Maybe I should hurry up. Okay, let's pray. Dear God, help everyone to stay awake and to hopefully learn something today. Amen. When I was trying to think about what to preach today, I asked my dad what he does to get ready. He told me that he just finds a sermon on the internet and copies and pastes it. But I wanted to write my own sermon instead. So today I wanted to talk about a story that I always thought was cool. This story comes from the book of Acts and is about two guys named Paul and Silas. Paul and Silas were walking around preaching and telling people about Jesus. While they were doing this, they made some people mad. To get back at them, the people told the cops that they were breaking the law and causing a lot of trouble. The people convinced the judge that Paul and Silas were so bad that the judge ordered them to be stripped and beaten with rods. Would you believe that I have never been stripped and beaten with a rod? I'm sure Leah has, though. She's really sassy. So Paul and Silas are beaten with rods. They're locked up in a maximum security cell in the prison. The doors are barred shut, and they are even chained to the wall. Also something that would be kind of cool to try, Leah. Maybe Jada, too. So Paul and Silas are beaten with rods and then locked up in a maximum security cell in the prison. The doors are barred shut and they are chained to the wall. The judge ordered the jailer to watch over Paul and Silas carefully. He did not want them escaping and causing more trouble. So around midnight, after Paul and Silas had been stripped naked, beaten, thrown in a maximum security prison, and chained to the wall, they were singing praise songs to God. If I were to be beaten, stripped, and thrown in jail, I probably wouldn't be singing praise songs to God. I think maybe they were hit over the head one too many times. But the cool thing is, they weren't just singing to themselves, but all the other prisoners were listening to them. Well, while they were singing these songs, a giant earthquake hit the jail. This thing was so big that it opened up all the prison doors and unlocked their shackles. And I don't know about you, but I would probably have sprinted out the door faster than Uncle Mark running because someone said there was cake. So the jailer wakes up and sees that all the jail doors are open. He thinks that he's in a lot of trouble because everybody got out. He was supposed to guard the prisoners carefully, and he knows that he's probably going to be executed because they all escaped. So he gets out his sword and is ready to kill himself when Paul shouted, "Stop it! Don't kill yourself! We didn't leave." When the jailer heard Paul shout, he got some lights and saw that all the prisoners were still really there. The jailer then went to Paul and Silas' cell and thanked them and asked them what he must do to be saved. And I think this part is really awesome. One of the big things that we can learn from this story is that actions speak louder than words. Paul and Silas were so loving that they stayed in the jail just so that the jailer wouldn't get killed. And because they stayed, the jailer wanted to know more about Jesus. It wasn't because of what they said, it was because of what they did. Truly loving others is the best way to tell them about Jesus. As Christians, we are supposed to be just like this, but most of the time we say one thing and do the other. Nobody wants to listen to somebody who says one thing and does the opposite. My uncle Randy drives like he's in the Indy 500. He's passing cars left and right on the highway. We were on vacation. We were parked by a military airport trying to see some fighter jets that were taking off. But where we were parked, we were missing the jets. So Uncle Randy decided that we would drive down the road and try to find a better spot to see them. I looked from the backseat, "We're going to miss them!" And Uncle Randy pushed that gas pedal all the way to the floor, and we were just flying down the road. I'm pretty sure we were going faster than the jets. So Uncle Randy, now do you think when Malachi gets older, that Uncle Randy is going to be able to tell Malachi to drive slow and he's going to listen? You can't tell somebody else to drive slow. It needs to be like a flash. You gotta show people first if you want them to listen and believe you. Do you think when me, Dana, and Leah are going to listen when Uncle Mark's be patient? Uncle Mark is so impatient that he almost killed a little girl on vacation because he got so mad playing mini golf, he whacked the ball as hard as he could and it ricocheted off the rock and went flying towards her. Now, should we listen when he says be patient? When it's like 100 degrees outside during the summer, my parents always tell me to go outside. Whenever they are sitting inside watching TV in an air-conditioned room, then why would we want to go outside and sweat our butts off while they're sitting in front of the air conditioner? This is just like when people say that you're supposed to love your neighbor, but then do the exact opposite. You can't tell somebody to clean the house when you're making it dirty. Can't tell somebody not to lie if you don't tell the truth. Can't yell at someone for raising their voice. Can't hit someone for hitting. People don't want to listen to someone who does what they tell people not to do. But they will listen to someone who shows them before he tells them. The jailer didn't ask Paul and Silas about Jesus when they were singing, but he didn't want to hear about Jesus until they stayed in the jail instead of escaping. Truly loving others is the best way to tell them about Jesus. Paul and Silas tell the jailer and he is saved. He believes them because they showed him just how much they cared about him. Not only does the jailer get saved, but he takes Paul and Silas back to his home so that they can tell his whole family. They all accept Jesus as their Savior and were baptized. This family was saved, not because Paul and Silas said one thing and did the other, but they were saved because Paul and Silas cared enough to show the jailer how much they loved him. They loved him enough to stay. We have to make sure that we don't say one thing and do the other. It is more important to show love than it is to just talk about it. Because truly loving others is the best way to tell them about Jesus. Let's pray. Dear God, please help us to remember the story of Paul and Silas. Help us not to just talk about loving people, but to help us remember that the best way to bring people to Jesus is to show them love through our actions.